and he sees the struggles of this life. He knows the pain you're going through, and that's not how he will. God made this world perfect. We were made perfect by our Creator. But man has gone astray. We have turned each and every one on our own way. We thought that we could find meaning in other things. We thought we could find pleasure and purpose and value in other things outside of God. Because the natural man is enmity against God. God doesn't want to be your enemy. He wants you to love him. He wants you to know him. Jesus Christ has come that we might know God. And this is eternal life, that they may know you, the only true God, and Jesus Christ, whom you have sent. My friends, it's a painful walk. I know it. I know it. I know what you're feeling like. It's a painful walk on this planet. There is pain awaiting at every corner. But my friends, you don't have to get high. You don't have to get drunk. The answer is the Holy Ghost. The answer is the Spirit of Jesus. He's the answer to all the pain you suffer. The loneliness, the isolation, the prejudice, the hatred, the bitterness. All of this is because of sin. All the evil of this world, all the wars, the killing, the rapes, the attacks, the murders. Everything is caused by sin. And you see, sin is our enemy. But the devil has deceived us into thinking that sin is our friend. No, 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 my friends. Sin is our enemy. It will encapsulate us. It will ensnare us. And it will bind us in chains that we cannot break free of. And my friends, I was chained. I know what it's like to be chained with no hope. I didn't want to live anymore. I tried everything this world tells me to do, but something was missing in my life. And if you can feel with me today, I ask you this question. When you're laying in bed tonight and you're looking up to the ceiling, ask you this question. Am I sure there isn't a God? Because it's good news. The good news is God does want to know you. He wants to come and dwell at home with you. He wants to come and have communion with you to ease your pain. To ease your sorrow, the sufferings of this life would build up around us. So that you think that suicide is an option. That suicide is the only way. It's the only way to stop this pain that we all feel every single day. I know it because I've been there. I know what it's like to live without Christ. I know how pointless this life is apart from God. I know how hard it can be to try and find meaning, try and find value, try and be accepted by people. To try and find something that could fill this void in my soul. But my friends, nothing can fill that void. Nothing other than Jesus. That pain we all feel. That quest which we don't know what we're trying to achieve. Deep down, you don't realize it. But you're searching for God. You're searching for your Creator. You've been deceived, just like I was deceived. And you don't realize this. There's been layer upon layer of deception. But deep down within the hearts of everyone, we're searching for our Creator. And God has sent the Spirit, His Spirit into us, by whom we cry out, Abba, Father, calling God, Daddy. That's what Jesus wants for you. He wants you to call your Creator, Daddy. Now this is perfect. This is the perfect gospel of Jesus Christ. Everything you've ever done, are doing, or will do, could be forgiven. You could be made perfect in the sight of your holy Creator. He could welcome you into his eternal home. How? Believe in the truth. Believe in Jesus. It doesn't ask us to fill 613 laws. He asks us one thing. Believe in the Lord Jesus. That's all it takes, my friends. And if the Holy Spirit is working on your heart right now and moving you towards this, there's got to be more to life than this. This pain that we all experience, looking into each of his eyes and hoping for more than what we see staring back at each other. We're hoping for more. We are disappointed on a daily basis because deep down we all need love. Everyone needs love. You could be a billionaire, you could be homeless. We all need to be loved. We all need the communion that comes from our Creator. We all need this, my friend. So when you look into each other's eyes, just remember this, that God made us all perfect. We were perfect before the fall. There was no sin. Adam and Eve walked around naked with no shame. There was no shame. Not even when they were naked, they had no shame. But you see, sin makes us ashamed. It pains us. It troubles us. It strives us. And Jesus has come to set us free, to give us hope in this life. hope which no one can take away from you. Jesus said, peace I leave with you, my peace I give to you, not as the world gives do I give unto you. Let not your heart be troubled, neither let it be afraid. You have heard me say that I am going away, and I will come back to you and receive you again to myself.